Uganda Wildlife Authority is set to iron out human-wildlife conflicts between Queen Elizabeth National Park and its closest neighbors. Community conservation programs put in place to harmonize the situation are yet to yield much, following the recent reports of locals killing lions in April, and they have now continued to vow to take on wild animals that have destroyed their gardens. Isaac Muhindo, one of the affected farmers, says his family won't die at the expense of elephants destroying his garden.
We have been affected so much with these wild animals. Very many farmers here, we use loans to ensure that we yield something for our families. Let's be, when we invest in farming, it is one way that we normally use to raise school fees for our children, even food for home consumption.
Muhindo said that what worsens the situation is that the park management and Uganda Wildlife Authority have been playing hide and seek as the locals seek their compensation.
I can just say they have not helped us all that, because me as a farmer, I've always had some funds from UWA in stories that they normally give us some funds per year, but that fund, I've never heard of it. It has not helped any single farmer. Farmers, all their crops have been destroyed to nothing, and no one has been compensated. Yet they say the government oftenly sends some money to support farmers who suffer this animal destruction of their crops.
Farmers have now vowed to kill the wild animals, especially elephants, that are accused of attacking their crops. Zephanias Muhera, the Kanyangea LC1 chairperson, asked farmers to contain their anger as they wait for response from Queen Elizabeth National Park management. He, however, accused them of acting slow to compensate residents, adding that it's not fair for farmers to be hit by famine at the expense of wild animals. Of recent, Edward Asulu, the chief warden of the park, told Urban TV that it's true that the relationship between the park and nearby natives is not good due to stray animals. He, however, said that they have plans of making trenches around the park so as to bar elephants from attacking farmers' gardens. The human-wildlife conflict is a raging challenge in most Ugandan national parks and communities, and of recent, Mbarara University's social science researchers suggested that Uganda Wildlife Authority should revise the policy of compensation. This report was filed by Halson Kagure for Urban TV.